maturity stages. He's a student here at NMSU. Govinda, please, it's all yours.
Thank you, Dr. Sebion. Everybody is able to see my slides?
Yes.
Yes.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Govinda Sapkora. I'm a PhD student from Department of Plant and Environmental Sciences, New Mexico State University. Today, I'm going to talk about dynamics of nutrients in jujube at different maturity stages. If you already don't know about jujube is a fruit, which is also commonly known as Chinese date. It comes under family Ramnaceae, and it was originated in China 4,000 years ago. Researchers working with jujube also claim that it should be recognized as a superfruit. Here are some reasons why. Because it blossom and even bear fruit in the same year as planting or grafting. It avoids late frost and biennial bearing. It has a light pest pressure. It is drought tolerant, so it is suitable for arid and semi-arid climate like New Mexico. It can be cultivated under wide range of soil condition. It has diversified uses. I'll come to this point later on. And it is rich in nutrients and bioactive compounds. Talking about the diversified uses of jujube can be consumed fresh. It can be consumed in dried form. And it can also be processed into different value-added products such as wine, candied jujube, jam, and different fillings for different pastries. Jujube can be consumed fresh at three different edible maturity stages. They are creamy, half red, and full red. From these pictures, we can clearly see the differences between creamy, half red, and full red based on the appearances. Jujube has been an integral part of traditional Chinese medicine because of its nutritional values and medicinal properties. Some of the important nutrients in jujube are phenolics, ascorbic acid, sugars, and cyclic adenosine monophosphate. Phenolics are secondary metabolites that are synthesized in plants as a defense mechanism against pests, diseases, UV radiation, and different environmental stresses. Phenolics and ascorbic acid exhibit antioxidant property. They scavenges the free radicals produced in human body and limits the development of diseases. In this picture here, we can see the antioxidant mechanism. Generally, the antioxidant compounds donates electron to the free radical and make it stable so that that radical is no longer capable of developing the diseases. It has been reported that jujube is effective against cardiovascular illness, neurodegenerative diseases, dementia, diabetes, cancer, arthritis, and so on. Cyclic AMP has cardiovascular functions such as heart rate and contractility. Ascorbic acid, apart from exhibiting antioxidant property, it is also responsible for the synthesis of collagen, carotenoid, and the neurotransmitter. Objectives of this study were to help profiling different nutrients in jujube during maturation, to compare and contrast different bioactive compounds in jujube grown at different geographical locations. For this study, we followed randomized design with number of replication 3. We harvested jujube in year 2018 and 2019. In 2018, we harvested 4 cultivars from Alcalde, New Mexico, and we harvested jujube for 3 to 4 harvest dates, depending on cultivar in 14 days interval. In year 2019, we harvested jujube, 3 to 4 cultivars from 3 different locations, Leindecker, Los Lunas, and Alcalde. Leindecker is in the southern part, whereas as we go north, we will see Los Lunas and Alcalde. We can also see the differences in the altitude for these 3 locations here. And harvest date were 4 to 5 harvest dates in 14 days interval. Samples were freeze-dried and used for quantification of different parameters. Parameters we assessed were moisture content, total soluble solids, total phenolic content, proanthocyanidins, ascorbic acid, and antioxidant activity. For total phenolic content, we use Follin spectrophotometric method. For fluoroanthocyanidins, we followed colorimetric method. Ascorbic acid was quantified using visual titration method, and antioxidant activity was measured using two different methods, DPPH and FRAP. For this presentation, I'm gonna focus on phenolic compounds and the antioxidant activity. Let's go to the results. In this graph, we can see the change in total phenolic content with maturity in year 2018. We can see that the total phenolic content has a decreasing trend as maturity progresses. For Lang and Sugarcane, we can see that the total phenolic content is the highest on 28th August, while for Septemberlate and Lee, it is highest on 11th September. On 28th August, Lang and Sugarcane were at creamy stage, while Lee and Septemberlate were at creamy stage on 11th September. Here is the graph that shows change in proanthocyanidin content with maturity for year 2018. We can see that proanthocyanidin content also followed this similar trend, same trend, decreasing trend like total phenolic content did. However, for all cultivars, proanthocyanidin content is highest on 28th August. At this harvest date, Lang and Sugarcane were at creamy stage. Lee was in the transition to be the creamy stage. However, Septemberlate was still immature. It was not even close to the creamy stage because of its growth habit. It is actually late maturing variety. This table show change in antioxidant activity using DPPS and FRAP method. In this table on the top, we can see the trend of antioxidant activity using DPPH method. We can see that the antioxidant activity is highest for all cultivars for the jujubes harvested on September 11. On September 11, Lang and Sugarcane were at creamy stage, while Lee was at half red stage. Septemberlate was close to the half red, but not exact half red. If we look on the bottom part on the lower table, we can see FRAP antioxidant activity. FRAP antioxidant activity was the highest for Lang and Sugarcane on August 28th. At this harvest date, they were at creamy stage, while for Lee, it is highest on September 11. Lee was at half red stage at this harvest stage. Let's go to the results from year 2019. I have not included all the results, all the graphs from 2019. However, we found the similar trend of total phenolic content, proanthocyanidin content, and antioxidant activity. They actually significantly decreased with maturity for all cultivars from all different locations that we studied. However, decreasing trend in total phenolic content and proanthocyanidin was obvious only after the creamy stage. In year 2019, we harvested jujubes at 4 to 5 different harvest dates. They were from immature to the full red, but we found that the decreasing trend in phenolic compounds was obvious only after the creamy stage. This graph shows what is the differences or the comparison in total phenolic content and proanthocyanidin content at three different harvest locations. They were LK denotes Leyendecker, LL means Los Lunas, and AL means alkali. Here in this graph A, we can see that total phenolic content is significantly higher for Los Lunas and alkali compared to Leyendecker for creamy and half red stage. However, in full red stage, there is no significant difference in TPC for Lee variety harvested from three different locations. In this graph B, we can see the proanthocyanidin is also following the same trend like total phenolic content did. Proanthocyanidin is higher for lostlness and alkali compared to Leyendecker in creamy and half red. However, there is no significant difference in proanthocyanidin content for full red jujubes harvested from three different locations. So what could be the reason for alkali having the highest total phenolic content? It could be because according to Son et al. And Gao et al., drought and high altitude play a positive role in jujube phenolic content. And if we look at the elevation of three different locations, alkali, altitude of alkali is higher, followed by lostlness and Leyendecker. So the question might arise why there is no significant difference in total phenolic content and proanthocyanidin content for three different locations at full ready stage. It could be because polyphenol oxidase, which is responsible for the conversion of phenolic compounds into highly reactive quinones, might be more active for alkali and lostlness compared to the Leyendecker. I need to dig further into what factors might have caused the increase in activity for the polyphenol oxidase to make a robust claim. So here in these two pictures, so we can see in picture in graph A, we can see antioxidant activity measured using FREP method, how they compares for different locations. We can see that antioxidant activity using FREP method is significantly higher for alkali compared to lostlness, followed by Leyendecker. It is the same, the trend is same for creamy and half red. However, there is no significant difference in FREP antioxidant activity for full red jujubes harvested from three different locations. It is, however, in graph B, we can see that DPPS antioxidant activity is not following the same trend that FREP did. So the trend is not very obvious. It is scattered. So the reasons could be individual phenolic profile vary with maturity stage and also with cultivar. And DPPS antioxidant activity of phenolic compounds may also vary. In different cultivars and in different maturity stages, we have different types and different concentration of phenolic compounds. And those phenolic compounds, the potential of those phenolic compounds to scavenge free radicals also vary according to different studies. So based on my results, we can conclude that interaction effect of cultivar, maturity, and geographical location affects the total phenolic content and antioxidant activity. Jujubes from alkali and lostlness has significantly higher total phenolic content, proanthocyanidin content, and antioxidant activity compared to Leyendecker for creamy and half-red fruits. Taking jujube color, consumer preference, phenolic content, and antioxidant activity into consideration, we can say that jujube harvested at creamy stage or half-red stage, depending on cultivar, is good for health benefits. That will be all. Now the floor is open for the questions. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Govinda, for your presentation. It's nice to know about jujube. I don't know, is there any question from our students?
Yes, you mentioned at the end that it's good for a lot of health benefits. I'm not sure if you elaborated on exactly which health benefits. I think you mentioned cancer and diabetes in the beginning, correct?
Right. So it's because jujube is well known for the antioxidant activity. So antioxidant activity is attributed to total phenolic content and ascorbic acid. There are some other nutrients also, but the general trend for those nutrients that has a beneficial effect to the health decreases significantly as maturity progresses. So when we consume jujube at creamy stage or half-ready stage. Those are the edible maturity stages. We can get health benefits. That means we will get more antioxidant in our body, which will scavenge the free radicals. Because of different factors, our day-to-day activities, pollution, and diet, free radicals are produced in human body. So if we consume jujubes at creamy stage or half-ready stage, depending on the cultivar, as shown in the result, we can scavenge those radicals, which also helps to limit the development of diseases such as cardiovascular illness, you know, and also cancer. There are some reports outside, and that shows that it is also very effective for cancer, dementia, and there are some other diseases which can be controlled consuming jujubes because of its bioactive compounds. Did I answer your question?
Yes, thank you. And you had a great presentation.
Thank you.
Govinda, I have a question. As you mentioned, you suggested we should consume jujube when it's in a creamy stage. Does it have like a sour flavor or astringent?
When we consume it at creamy stage, probably it is not that sweet. It's not even sour, but vitamin C concentration is higher for creamy stage. But it's not sour, but it's not sweet as well. So the sweetness increases as the maturity progresses. So at creamy stage, it is kind of sweet, but not really sweet. But at half-ready stage, it is sweet, and we don't experience any sour taste on it.
Okay, thank you very much. So I think we're going to follow with our next speaker is Ricardo López.